Smart Fortwo 451. If your vehicle makes these sounds when you're putting it into gear, right there, you hear that? It slams into gear. So I'm going to show you how to fix that. So at the rear of the car, what you're going to want is an E10. It's basically reverse Torx, size 10. And you're going to get under here, and this is your clutch actuator. It's basically your clutch pedal. There's a bolt here, it's a bolt over here, and there's another one on the back over here I'm going to show you. And there's your last one right there in the middle of the screen. So you're going to want to remove those three and remove this electrical connector with the purple and red, this fat boy. So it's gonna have tabs on both sides. You're gonna wanna push it here and push it on the back end at the same time and lift up on it. So you're gonna remove this plus the three bolts. And in doing so, that will allow you to drop the clutch actuator. It's not under much pressure or anything like that. You can ignore that current positioning. That doesn't really matter because you're gonna set it in the middle and relearn it, no problem. I'm gonna show you how. Once you pull it out, it should look something like this. First thing we're gonna do is give it a quick clean so it will be a much nicer surface and part to work with. So the next step is to take a Torx T20 and remove six screws. There's gonna be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 over here. Once you do that, you'll be able to take off this plastic cover on the back. Let me show you how. As you can see, all six screws are identical. At this point, you'll be able to remove this black plastic cover here. As you can see, it comes off quite easy. It's a little bit of plastic shards, and that's from this area, because what's happening, as you can see, is from the factory, it comes with this white grease. It's pretty thick, good stuff, right? But it gets eaten away. See, there's no grease on the gears anymore. Just a little bit stuck here up against the aluminum wall. And the gears are completely grease-free. And what happens is, it's trying to move this piston here to press the clutch in. And because there's so much friction due to this not being lubricated anymore, the motor here has to keep applying more and more torque to try to move it. And it keeps applying it. And if you know anything about physics, to try and move something, you're going to keep applying force until it starts moving. And as I'm constantly increasing force on this ratchet here, for example, I'm constantly increasing the torque more and more and more until it overcomes the friction of the table. Same thing here. The motor is constantly increasing torque. It's holding, and then it just breaks because it overcomes the friction, and then it starts to move. And that's what that kick is, because the clutch cannot move smoothly back and forth. What's happening is it's not able to apply the clutch smoothly once you put it into reverse or into drive or whatnot. It can't apply the clutch smoothly, so it just forces it in, and that forces the gears to go in and out of position. So what we're going to do is we're going to shove this full of grease and then put everything back together. Now, as you can see, it's completely packed full of grease. I forced it. Basically, I put the tube at the joint here and I forced the grease down into there all throughout. Then over here, I packed it in using a screwdriver. At this point, I'm going to go ahead and put the cap back on, screw everything down, not too tight. As you can see, the type of screw, it's only about 4 foot-pounds, I don't know, 4 newton meters, somewhere around, not very much. I'm going to screw this tight, and I'm going to put it back on the car. There, everything's back on. It's not too tight. Here's a fun fact. Not only does this most of the time fix your clunk when you put it into drive or reverse, but a lot of the times, 9 times out of 10, this is also why your vehicle, when you put it into drive and you let off the brake, it accelerates very fast. Same problem here is it's gotta constantly apply the force, and same thing as removing force because of the friction there. The clutch moves too fast, so it'll accelerate fast. You press the brake, instead of accelerating normally slowly, it accelerates really fast right off the line. A lot of times this fixes it, so everything's done, much cleaner. Let's get it back on the car. So what we've done now is I've just put all three screws on, finger tight, but with enough space where you can slide it. And the position you're going to lock it in is you're going to lock it right at about the middle. You don't want it all the way out. You don't want it all the way in. Push it all the way in and feel where it stops and go out halfway. And that's where you want to tighten the bolts down. You want to tighten the two bottom ones first and then the one on the side. So bottom two first and then the one on the side. There, I got this one on. As you can see, it's tightened at about the halfway point. It doesn't have to be exactly right there, just roughly halfway. And the reason for that is you want this to have a little bit of preload, but not much. There's a spring in there. It will relearn its new position. And make sure you got the electrical connector hooked up. And at this point, let's test. So same thing, let's go ahead and start it. I'm currently on ramps, so I'm gonna roll off the ramps here. Breakdown. Let's get off these ramps. Anyway, so here we are, we're outside. So put into drive, nothing. Very small click, nothing. Nothing, nothing. The car's running. Let me open the window so you can hear it running. Nothing. Nothing. Now let me go onto a flat surface and show you just how slowly this thing accelerates now that the acceleration's been fixed. So release the pedal. Accelerating nice and slow. Stop. Release the pedal. Accelerating nice and slow. Back into reverse. Very slight click, and that's it. So that fixes the problem. And park this thing. What's going on is the actuator has too much friction. It can't move freely. Let me put it back into drive. Nice and quiet. So the actuator, it's not moving freely. And perfect. And it's just having issues. It can't move around and it gets stuck. And this simple fix cost like $2 for some grease. You probably have some grease just lying around at home, and your car's fixed. You have no more you have no more shifting issues. You have no more hard acceleration issues. Upon letting go of the brake, it fixes the shifting, fixes the braking. No more clunk, so no more hard use on your transmission. And this cost about $2. That's about it. Either way, I hope you learned something today. I seriously hope this helped you out, and you didn't have to go out and buy a transmission. You didn't have to buy a clutch actuator. You didn't have to spend any money on that. Just 20 minutes of your time, $2 in grease, and you're good to go. I hope you learned something today. Have a nice day.